Hallelujah! Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Good morning, everybody, and a very happy Easter to you all as we gather together for worship in the Abbey, and we welcome those who are joining us at home. It is truly wonderful to be able to be in person together as we celebrate Jesus' resurrection from the dead. Just to remind everybody, because it's been quite a while for some of us that we've been in church for communion, our wonderful side people team will guide you up when we come to communion. So don't worry about when you've got to move. They'll come and indicate when you can move forward. We just ask that you've sanitised your hands before you receive communion. So either at the central station here, or if you've got your own sanitiser, that's absolutely wonderful. And because we're back in church as well, it's been great joy this morning to read some bands of marriage, because we're looking forward to having a wedding very soon. I publish the banns of marriage between James Edward Fish and Clementine Martha Lucy Hodges, both of the parish of St. Denis Warminster, with a qualifying connection to this parish. This is the first time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why they may not marry each other, you are to declare it. So we pray for James and Clementine. Lord of love, we pray for James and Clementine. Be with them in all their preparations and on their wedding day. Give them your love in their hearts throughout their married life together. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Yeah.
So wonderful to have our choir back singing. Thank you, choirs. A brilliant way to start our service. We now turn to the little cream sheet you've got, which says, welcoming the Easter candle. Christ, yesterday and today. Alpha and Omega, all time belongs to him and all ages.
Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day when our Lord Jesus Christ was raised gloriously from the dead, crushing the power of sin and destroying the sting of death. Throughout the world, Christians celebrate the mighty power of God as Christ calls us out of darkness to share in his marvellous light. May we and all Christ's people shine as lights in the world to the glory of God the Father.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
So now we return to our yellow communion booklets. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. In baptism we died with Christ, so that as Christ was raised from the dead, we might walk in newness of life. Let us receive new light in him, as we confess our sins in penitence and faith. Father eternal, giver of light and grace, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in what we have said, in what we have said and done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have wounded your love and marred your image in us. We are sorry. Deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death, to make all things new in him. Grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be praise and honour, glory and might, now and in all eternity. Amen.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved. And she said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who had reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood out weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus said to her, Mary. She turned and said to him in Hebrew, Rabboni, which means teacher. Jesus said to her, Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, I have seen the Lord. And she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I wonder what you are going to do differently today because of today. After another time of lockdown, it may be that for many of us, seeing family and friends is at the top of our priority list. Catching up in person, sharing time together, and hearing all the news. It can only be a good thing. Will our lives be changed by being able to see other people, those we care about? It probably will, because that's the power of encounters with others. Easter Day is a day full of difference, of encounter, and lives being changed. At the end of a harrowing week, with Jesus being laid in a tomb, where the darkness of the early morning resonates with the darkness of the tomb and the feelings of Jesus's friends and followers, an incredible encounter takes place. Mary, in the midst of her grief and sadness, goes to the tomb so that she can pay her respects. An action that will be familiar to so many who have been bereaved, and most especially in the past year, when our remembering and respecting of those who have died has been interrupted by a situation beyond our control. But this is the first Easter day, and everything is different. Mary's grief and devastation is magnified when she sees that the tomb is empty. How much worse can things get? Mary, overwhelmed by her love for Jesus, weeps, because there is nothing else for her to do. Her love for Jesus knows no end, and the loss of his body is devastating. Mary's Easter encounter with the risen Christ changes everything. As Jesus lovingly calls her by name, the strength of their relationship is revealed, and their love for one another is clear. Not even death
and a cold tomb has ended this life-giving relationship. Now, in the power of the resurrection, their relationship changes into something new that will bring hope and life to others. Go, Jesus says to Mary. Go and tell others what you've seen and experienced. And that's exactly what Mary does. She becomes a witness and an evangelist for the good news of the gospel, that Jesus has risen, that love has overcome death and all that makes us less than human, that Jesus wants to share his love with every single one of us. Mary is the first in a long line of people who have called out, "I have seen the Lord," and changed lives. What are we going to do differently because of today? How might we witness to the glorious news of the resurrection of Jesus from the dead, which reveals that hope and joy can transform the darkest places in our hearts and lives? Perhaps today, and in the days to come, we can be like Mary. Simply tell someone that you have seen the Lord and what a difference that has made to your life. This news is so good, we mustn't keep it to ourselves. This Easter, let's do all that we can to spread the love of God so that together we can truly transform the world. Alleluia! Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Amen.
Join together now with our brothers and sisters at home, our brothers and sisters throughout the world, celebrating this Easter day as we profess our Easter faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father.
This morning the bidding is Jesus, Lord of life, and the response, in your mercy, hear us. We pray to Jesus, who is present with us to eternity. Jesus, light of the world, bring the light and peace of your gospel to the nations. Bless the church in every town and enable her to share your light with all. Jesus, Lord of life, in your mercy, hear us. Jesus, bread of life, give food to the hungry, and nourish us all with your word. Open our hearts and our hands to do what is right in your name. Jesus, Lord of life,
in your mercy, hear us.
Jesus, our way, our truth, our life, be with us and all who follow you in the way. Deepen our appreciation of your truth and fill us with your life. Let us shine with your light to share that light. Jesus, Lord of life,
in your mercy, hear us.
Jesus, good shepherd, who gave your life for the sheep, recover the straggler, bind up the injured, strengthen the sick, and lead the healthy and strong to new pastures. This morning, we pray for all affected in any way by the current crisis. For the scared, the lonely, the ill, for the key workers, for those in healthcare, the emergency services, the prison service, for all in education, for our local and national governments, and for those who are now making new plans for baptisms, for blessings, and for weddings. We pray by name, Jesus, Lord of life,
in your mercy, hear us.
Jesus, the resurrection and the life, We give you thanks for all who have lived and believed in you. We offer before you, raise us with them to eternal life. Jesus, Lord of life,
in your mercy, hear us.
Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Because this is Easter Day, obviously we can't get close to the people around us to share the peace, but we can do a very joyful social distance exchange of peace. I'm hoping that everyone at home will pick up our loving vibes which are coming down to you. So let's share the peace, everyone. Be present, Lord Jesus Christ, our risen High Priest. Make yourself known in the breaking of bread.
Amen.
The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father, and in these days of Easter, to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise and opened to them the gate of life eternal. And so, in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died. He had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice, made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. The body and blood of Christ keep you in eternal life. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of life, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection have delivered us from the power of our enemy, grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his risen life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise, that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
There are many traditions that we have on Easter. Coming to church is one. Again, it's wonderful to have everyone here and all those at home sharing in our worship. The other really important one, having a beautifully decorated church, having people singing, people showing us to our seats, is chocolate. Chocolate eggs. Hooray for chocolate eggs. So if you would like a chocolate egg, I will be distributing them like communion, but outside. So I'll be all sanitised. But don't feel any obligation to have one at all. And may they be for us today, signs of the new life that we share in. God the Father, by whose love Christ was raised from the dead, open to you who believe the gates of everlasting life.
Amen.
God the Son, who in bursting from the grave has won a glorious victory, give you joy as you share the Easter faith.
Amen.
God the Holy Spirit, who filled the disciples with the life of the risen Lord, empower you and fill you with Christ's peace.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
He is not here. He is risen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.